Hi, this is Sega Master System 2 Power Base. Now, I just saw this on eBay with my two favorite words for any console listing, not working. Grabbed it, it came with the console, four dead cartridges and two crappy controllers, non-official. And in this video, I'm gonna take a look and see if we can get it working, what's wrong with it, fix it, etc. Now, this one I got on eBay and it arrived not too long ago. It had some really just crap, absolute terrible controllers, fakey nothings. And it came with four games, which apparently also don't work. So we've got My Hero, World Grand Prix, Wonder Boy, and Sonic the Hedgehog 2. So I guess we'll see. I haven't actually looked at this yet. But yeah, let's dive into it. So, I mean, the physical case is actually in pretty good nick. It's a little bit dirty. It's got a couple of scratches, but in general, like the markings are a little bit bad, but like it's actually not too bad. The only issue with it is it's got some additions. So I don't actually know what that is. I'm going to guess that that's a power LED. Because these didn't come with a power LED from the factory. I don't know why you'd want to put a power LED in, but whatever. Anyway. And it also has this switch and these connectors. So just based on these, this is going to be a composite. So we've got just from the yellow, that'll be composite video. And then we'll have audio. Don't know why there's two since the Master System only generates mono. I'm guessing they just doubled it up. But we've got white and blue. It should be red, but whatever. And a switch, which I don't know what does, but because of the composite mod, I'm going to assume this is a PAL NTSC switcher, which is just a pin on the video controller that tells it which to output. But otherwise, on the bottom, it's in good shape as well. It's got all the original feet on there. Let's look, missing a, I don't know if you can see down there. Need my little torch thing, which has gone walkabout. Here we go, got my little Game Boy torch. So it's missing a couple of screws. So that one's... Can't even see down this hole. There you go. It's the dark abyss. That one's looking real rusty. That one's missing. That one's in there. And that one's in there. Okay, so we got shitty rusty screw and two okay ones. And just from the inside here, you can also see there is a wire. Interesting. Let's crack this open and see what we see. That's not a happy screw. Okay, ready for the big reveal. Okay, I had to sit down. All right, I've got my bench supply ready for 9 volts. I also have this set to center negative because I know this is center negative, so let's plug that in, switch it on, and the power switch here, and we are drawing absolutely nothing. No volts whatsoever. Well, no current, sorry. Let's just double check that we are getting voltage. Power thingy here. we should be... Three, what the hell? Oh, okay, so it's a little bit loose. Oh, I've got these backwards as well. It's a little bit loose, but yeah, we are getting our 9 volts and still drawing nothing, so that's a little bit loose. Connector, but still nothing. Actually, what I want to do is I might just check the regulator here is getting some voltage. Yeah, 8 point something. Yeah, that's good enough. Are we outputting anything? No. Well, that might be as simple as that. Dead regulator. Yeah, nothing. Could just be the voltage regulators there is dead. I don't know what all this crap is. So this is... Black is going through this tube, which was hot glued to there, and that's going to pin one on the, this is the RGB encoder. We've got one wire going from ground on the voltage regulator to one leg on this switch, and then the other leg on the switch is going to ground also. And yes, I was correct. So this, the middle wire is going to pin whatever it is, it's 50 something, on the VDP here, which tells it. So you put it in, you ground it out to make it NTSC, and then you pull it high to 5 volts to tell it to output PAL. So... this is permanently in NTSC mode, because no matter which way you flip this switch, it's going to switch white to black, which is ground, or white to red, which is also ground on the 5 volt regulator. Okay. Hey, it's Editing Nick here. I just wanted to clarify, since I actually realized while editing this, that switch is actually illuminated. It's not switching between the two sides. It's actually only switching on and off the right and the middle posts there. So that left wire, the red one going to ground, is kind of correct if the white wire was actually giving us some kind of voltage source. But because where it's connected to, that pin on the VDP is lifted out of the PCB, it's never seeing anything but ground. So the LED would never work. And when that switch is turned off, the pin on the VDP would actually just be floating, not connected to anything, and probably in an unknown state. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, back to the video. And then over here... So yeah, the two audio are just bust. They're just connected directly, and we've got our negatives there. So the green wire here must be going to the output, and the white, the yellow wire here on the yellow connector is going through a, what are you? You're a 220 microfarad capacitor into, I mean, what I'm gonna guess is like a 75 ohm resistor, and then that'll be going into the video out, which is this video controller chip here. It actually takes RGB in and then outputs the signals necessary for the RF signal, but it also outputs just composite. So you just pick that composite up, run it through a 75 termination, and out to your out to your TV. I'm just gonna remove all this crap because I just because like look at it like come on this is atrocious like I just this is just heat shrink tube. Why isn't it heat shrinked? It's just I don't understand why this was going to pin 1 on the VDP. There's so much ground. And this wire should have been going to... I just can't with this right now. I don't understand what's going on. This is amazing. I think it's gonna be a 75 ohm. I've never been good at remembering the resistor charts. Let's just measure it. 82. Okay. Okay. That's much better. Yeah, let's take the switch out if we can get it out. All right, and we'll leave these for now. And I'll probably replace those as well. Actually, I'm very likely just going to get another case for this just to replace these, because I'd prefer to not mar the original case, and I'd just actually remove the RF out and put a couple of connectors through these holes if I can, or maybe just a cable out, but we'll see. So let's actually extract the board from the case as well, since we're gonna have to desolder this 7805. Okay. And there's our board. Oh, we've got a bit of rust in there. Some reflowed pins. Bodge. What's that bodge for? It's from a cap to ground pin. That's interesting. Why is that there? It seems like it should already be connected. That's some more hot glue. Alright, so let's take a good look. So we've got our... This is our Z80 CPU. Not sure what these are. LC3664. I'm gonna guess that's gonna be DRAM of some kind. This might be a BIOS. Down here we have two NEC 416815s. They're gonna be our SRAM. That's our video processor. This will be the, I think it's a, it's not a gate array, it might be a gate array. Can't remember actually. Anyway, and this is our video control chip. That's a Sony CXA1145P. Actually a pretty simple board. And yeah, apart from, we've got some rework on the, just some flux really on the switch. The big components, the switches, the regulator, which looks like just absolutely shoddy work. It's fully rusted on. Yeah, I'll definitely have to take that out. And the RF module and the power thingy here, so... Yeah. Okay, well, yeah, let's start by removing the 705. Two very rusted screws, and we've got a little heat sink here which is soldered down, so I'll probably just leave that. Let's get some fresh solder onto here. Should just be able to heat these through. And that'll drop out. And then we'll clean these things up. It's a good bit of Soder-Wick. Alrighty, so let me grab a new 7805. We have a big tube of them. So. One. Now, let's just double check that we do have the right parts. This is the original 7805CT, and I'll be replacing it with a 7805CV. So this is the, I believe, the higher current handling version thereof. It can handle up to 1.5 amps, which should be ample for this system. Let's plug that in there. Let's just be thorough. Add a touch of some, this is, blown out. Silicon heat transfer compound. So I'll just pop a bit on the back of the, not that it really needs it, but anything helps. Alright. And I'll just, I'll screw this back in before soldering. Okay. Cool. Okay. Now, let's plug that back in, and let's just see if we get any current draw this time. Yes, so now we're getting 0.3 amps. And just double check. So we've got a little bit of warmth from the CPU and nothing else. Okay. And yeah, this connector is not great, so let's see if there's something wrong with that. I don't know if it's actually, I think it's a loose solder joint. I think it's actually loose down the barrel connector there. Could also just be using the wrong plug. Yeah, that seems fine. Anyway, we can fix that later. I don't think I've got any of that type of D-sub of barrel jack handy at the moment, so I don't think I'd be able to replace that, but for now, let's look at, yeah, so you were dead, 7805CT. Now let's look at getting our composite video working again, so ideally what I'd like to do is get this pin back down without damaging it. I don't really care about switching this between PAL and NTSC. So let's first of all clear out that pin. Is, where are we? Hey, I'm blind. There we go. We are this pin here. See if we can get that pin bent back down. Hmm. that closed. And there we go. Pin fixed. I'd still really like to get rid of all this hot glue. I might come back with a heat gun and just wipe it all off at some later point. But that pin is now resolved, so we can look at getting our connector connected. Now, what we're going to do is get an actual 75 ohm resistor. On the bottom here, I don't understand what this jumper is for. I wonder if that's a factory bodge, because it looks like it's connecting this capacitor, the negative lead, which already goes underneath, to pin one of this, the RGB encoder, which doesn't really make sense, because it's effectively grounding out this capacitor. Unless I'm looking in the wrong, I am looking at the wrong pin, okay. So it's actually grounding out this capacitor. No, it's connecting from ground to ground. I don't understand why it's doing that. So, let me look. This pin here, on one end of this jumper wire, this bodge, is going to this pin right here, which is on the grounder plane. That other wire is going to pin one here of this IC, which, as you can see, connects to, what's that, pin 6, 7, and pin 24. Now, if we flip it over, pin 1 here is connected to pin 24, which is also on the ground plane. So that wire is doing nothing. I don't know if that's a factory bodge. It doesn't look like it. I'm going to remove it. I don't understand what is going on with this system. The hot glue is a pretty good giveaway that this is not a factory bodge either. Now, let's begin. 75 ohm resistor. So we want to connect that to the pin 20, which is that one there, which is the video out on this chip here. So let's get, I'm going to do it on the back of the board as well, because I hate junk on the front of the board like this. I'd really like to clean this up fully, but yeah. Like I said, we've got pin 20, which is on the back here. So we've got 24, 23, 22, 21. There's pin 20 right there. So let's connect this here. Let's do a little bit of a bend and clip of that. Add some solder in here. Pin 20. And that's our video out. And then we can get a bit of wire. Let's just get way too much wire for now. And we want to connect that to pin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, which is the audio pin. So let's do the same thing. And let's get some yellow wire. Again, way too much. Do the same thing to the other side of that resistor. Now, just for posterity, I will also grab my big thing of colored heat shrink. I'll grab a little bit of yellow and we'll do, say, that much. Run it down this length of the wire. Okay, now we need a ground. So let's just grab a little bit of black. Probably still way too much. And let's look at where we can do that. So if we run our wires, we'll put our board back in for starters. We'll put our wires here. So there's our white. And there's our yellow. And our ground, well, let's just pick it up. No, no, just pick it up off of that. Horrible slop job. I still kind of want it coming up from the bottom like the others, so let's yeah, where did I put the black wire? There it is. Let's do the same. Okay, so we've got our video, our audio. Let's try and remove these old wires. Oh wow, okay. No wonder I couldn't get it out. Yeah, I'm guessing that's going to be the same, so let's just clip this here. And I'm just gonna actually remove this one entirely. Because I don't want it there. Okay. So we've got our ground wire there. Let's clip that out there. Okay. Your audio wire here. And finally, our composite lead. Let's run that down and under. The cleanliness goes to about there. Okay, and there's our connection. So, now, let's give this a test. Okay, get our video, plug our video in that one, and our audio, just do the left channel in this plug, power. Let's flick on our power supply, and what do we get? There's our Sega logo. And Alex the kid in Miracle World. Cutie. That's a pretty good looking signal as well. Oh, and yeah, so this power connector definitely needs some work. There we go. It's in a good spot there. Now, I'm just gonna test this out with one of these crappy controllers. I have no idea what they're doing. Let's plug that in. Seem to work fine. Ah, there you go. I forgot to turn on my speakers. But, yep, now we're getting sound well. Oh man, it's been so long. Come on. Come at me. Alright. Pretty easy. It looked like the main issue with this board was the 5-volt regulator was dead. That was this 7805. It just wasn't outputting anything. And the horrible botch job of a composite mod that was done in here with the switching and just awful wires. So what I might do now is try out some of these games. So this is my hero. I've never actually played this game before. So this will be interesting. There we go. Can we get a Sega logo? Oh, and still Alex the Kid. Right. So at this point, I don't know if it's the connector or if it's the game. Let's just pop the game open. Unfortunately, I don't actually have any other Master System games. I've never owned a Master System personally, so I don't know. Well, that could do it. Look at that. Capacitor is just completely junked. Broken traces. Just gonna reflow this cartridge really quickly. Okay. What do we get? The Sega logo again. And it's still Alex Kid. Yeah, so. Not sure. Is this one? Could actually just be a dead cartridge. Might be dead connectors or something as well. Connectors look kind of fairly clean. None of these traces on the cart are bad, so this cart looks fine. Let's try the other carts. So we got World Grand Prix. World Grand Prix. Okay. This one seems to be working. Cool. Wonder Boy. Also seems to be taking a while. Wonder Boy. That one's working. Good. And this one is really fairly beaten up. We got Sonic the Hedgehog. Or Nick the Hedgehog 2. Software error. Oh, that's an interesting one. Let's take a look inside there. Screws look weird. What the hell? Oh. Dropped it. Oh yeah, that screw is very weird. Look at that. It's much too long. Not the right type. And to space it out, whoever's done that has added a couple of washers. Okay. So I'm guessing someone's tried fixing this cartridge in the past as well. I wonder if it had the same level of workmanship as the composite mod. Okay. Your card looks fine immediately. Connectors are a bit crabby. Not actually that dirty though. And none of the traces are broken. Whoa! What the hell's going on there? Looks like someone's tried flowing the pins with solder. I'm guessing they were trying to fix the cartridge and just decided to add some solder to these pins for reasons. Okay, so otherwise, those lines look fine. I don't know why anyone would add solder. I can't actually see any of them are broken. I could continuity test them, but I'm pretty certain that they're all going to be fine. And all of the contacts on the pins for the ROM and the capacitors here look solid. So I'm guessing this ROM is damaged, but let's try it now that I've cleaned that up a little bit. See if we still get that software error. No. No, we don't. We get a working Sonic the Hedgehog 2 cartridge. So this is the same as the Sonic the Hedgehog, but it's the reduced version that's on. That's a bit weird though. It should have shown the logo by now. Looks like it's missing some sprites? Oh, there we go. Okay. That's weird. Yeah, this is the cost-reduced version of Sonic the Hedgehog 2 that is the same as the Game Gear version. Because the Game Gear and the Master System share a lot of the same hardware. So if we... I think I freaked out just then by plugging the controller in. Still starting. We can skip the logo. Dive straight into it. By pressing start. There we go. Yeah. Yeah, it looks fine. A little bit of color weirdness. Oops. Oh. Definite color weirdness. Oops. I don't know if that's the cartridge or if it's the console. Anyway. Yeah. So there you go. I'm gonna stop playing games because I'll be here all night. Terrible at them. But yeah, there we go. The Sega Master System 2 repaired. Get the Sonic out of here. With just a few small fixes. And there we go. Now, I'm going to need to pull this down again at some point in the future because I want to clean off that... the rest of that hot glue, and I'm going to need to replace the AC adapter barrel jack because it's kind of dodgy. And yeah, like I said, I think I might get a replacement case for this just to replace these holes, and I'd probably eventually also replace this with just a wire coming out of the RF out here, or maybe I'll do a multi-pin connector and then use a multi-AV type connector, the TRRS 3.5mm jack that has the breakout for composite audio as well. Commonly found on like camcorders and things like that, so yeah, I could put one of those jacks in there onto a little board. But yeah, the only other one that I can't figure out is my Hero, but this looks in healthy condition, so it must be the ROM. I might see what I can do, but otherwise, Master System 2, a few games, and some crappy controllers to play with. Not too shabby. Thanks for watching.